What is going on, YouTube? It's your boy Lil Mike Mike 6, and today I'm playing with Predator on some Mortal Kombat X, and I'm still saying Predator is a beast. Oh my god, Predator is a beast. Now, it might look like I don't know what I'm doing when I'm playing with Predator, but trust me, I know exactly what I'm doing. Predator has such mix-up game that is crazy. Like, he doesn't really have like any low overhead moves in one string or any overhead low strings. I don't think he does. I might have to go and like double check or something and just check out all of his strings just to double check or whatever. But I know he has two strings that look almost exactly alike, and one of them has an overhead and the other has a low. Now, this dude Mad Dog here, he's really good. He said he hadn't been playing the game that long, but I mean, this dude was really good though. He was blocking everything I was throwing at him. Sometimes I would get through though. I would kind of surprise him a little bit and kind of mix it up a little bit and then trick him, and you know, he would kind of fall for it sometimes, not all the time. He's actually a lot better blocking Predator than my normal opponents. Normally I just kind of run through people like it's nothing, but this dude here, I managed to pull off a 51% combo on him though. When he pulls out Kung Jin kind of later on, I believe it's I can't remember. I'll let you guys know when I get there, but anyways, he's really good at blocking. Now, what I mean about the strings is Predator has a 1-3 string. If you hold back his back 1-3 string, well, actually I said that wrong. It's his you hold back and it's his 3-1-1 string. That's what it is. That's a low, and then you get two hits after that that are just I believe they're high attacks. But that string and his 3-3-2 string, they look exactly alike. I mean, I'm not kidding, they look so much alike. And the difference is with his back 3-1 string, that one is, it starts off with a low, and then the 3-2 string, that one is the one that I'm doing mostly here, which is it has an overhead in the second hit. Now, I'm guessing this guy Mad Dog has played a lot of Predators before, before me, because he blocks perfectly on most of these attacks. Like, if you notice, he blocks low first and then he goes high every time I throw it. Look, see how he's kind of bouncing up, but he blocks it perfectly every time. But the only reason I'm catching him is because I keep throwing out those little traps there, and he has to try to figure out which string I'm going for, if I'm going for the low or the overhead, and which every time I pretty much go for the overhead, like that right there, because it makes it almost impossible for him to block, because that overhead that I do, it pushes him into the trap. So he has to be almost like flawless on his timing. He has to pretty much block immediately low and then immediately high, so it makes it really hard for him to block that trap, the hit with the trap. But also, Predator really, he really doesn't have any range attacks in Hunter variation. His Ken-2, or however you say that, I'm starting to figure out a lot of really good combos with that specific variation. I might actually start just using really that one, because I play one of my friends and I just completely dominated him with that specific variation. But then he kind of picked some really annoying characters, and finally I started losing with the Predator. My boy Lil Fred, but he's really good though. He's really good. He claims he beat Sonic Fox not too long ago, and I beat him like 22 matches in a row before he finally switched characters and started beating me. But I mean, to be honest, he's really, really, really good though. My boy Lil Fred's really good, and I should record next time I play with him. I might actually just go ahead and record some matches with me and Lil Fred so you guys can see how he plays. And that was actually the guy who I first started, like the first guy who I really met on Injustice that was really good. And he's one of the few people that I have played on here that are really, really good. I've played a few good players. But he's one of the really good players out here. You do not be lying. Oh my God. Sorry, I'm a little tired. I went and played a lot of basketball today, but I'm a little tired. I played possibly about 4 hours, and I'm just wore out right now. But anyways, like I said before, Predator is just extremely beast. Now, that attack that I just did there with the stick, or with his pole, or whatever you want to call it, the rod, or whatever, that attack has so much range. Now, normally, I always say Predator really doesn't have any like full range attacks or anything like that, but depending on what variation you're using, because with his Hishken 2, or however you pronounce that, with that specific variation, it feels sometimes like that's the only variation that has range in the attacks. Well, you can use the Hunter variation to your advantage, and you can use those traps, but you'll have to meter burn them pretty much to use them immediately, just like so, just like I just did there. And I've actually figured out over time how to do some really nice setups and how to end some combos even better than how I've been doing with Predator, because in these matches here, I'm not really finishing off combos. Like, look at that. I tried to do that because I knew he was going to be blocking low, waiting on it, and I tried to set him up for failure. The reason why I tried to give myself extra help is, look at that. Oh my God, that works every time. But the reason why I did that is because I gave myself health, so then that way he would see me doing that and look at it as a taunt, and then release block and try to attack me, and then the trap would snare him as soon as he would release block. But it didn't work out for me. And look at that. I love doing it. I love blowing the traps up because people don't expect this. It's so funny. They think they're safe when they're standing near it, and I just blow it up, and it's so funny. But I was trying to get the chip damage, and it's so funny. Check this out. Watch this. Look at this. I just run in right here. He starts beasting me right here with the combo, and I get my bar of meter, so it's over with for him. Nice little brutality right there. Oh my God, I love his snare trap brutality. It's so cool. The only thing that I don't like about the snare trap brutality is that the actual brutality itself doesn't completely finish until the stuff is all on the screen, and I don't really like that. I like the screen to be clear when the brutality finishes, and it just makes a better video. It doesn't show all the stats and all those things like that. I kind of like when the stats aren't on the screen when you know finishing up your match or doing a brutality or whatever. But his Kung Jin is really good. I mean, for him, he said he was a really new player, but to be honest, this dude played with so many characters. He said he only been playing for like a day or 2 days or whatever. But I don't believe that. I don't believe that at all. I think it's just because he started losing a lot of matches, and he just, I guess that was his way of saying, you know, hey. But look at this though. This dude does not look like he just started. I mean, he started off playing me with Ermac, and he was really good with Ermac. He was a lot better than most Ermacs that I played. And he claims he got this good from watching YouTube videos. He said that he had saw other people playing the game, and he just kind of watched them do stuff, and he learned like that. And he said he knew all the combos before he got the game. And he said before, when the game was released, he said all he did was just sat back and watch YouTube videos, and then once he got the game, then he already knew how to play. And honestly, I don't believe that. I don't believe that somebody can just remember combos like that. Like, look at this. I've practiced with Kung Jin for hours, and I don't do any of those combos like that. To be honest, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I felt Kung Jin was a annoying character to learn. I don't like doing some of the stuff that he does. I'm an intense comboer, but some of the stuff Kung Jin does, I just don't do it. I don't know. A lot of people say he's really easy, which I do believe that. I do believe Kung Jin's pretty easy character to learn, but he just didn't fit my style of playing, and honestly, I just didn't want to play with him. To me, Kung Jin feels like a character who... Predator. He kind of feels like... a character who can get out there and then just get punished all day long, which some people don't. Some people play with him a different way than I play with him. And I'll actually show you guys in the future some matches where I've beaten Kung Jin easily with Ermac. And that's why I really don't care to learn Kung Jin, is because he's, once people figure out how to actually beat him, then he'll pretty much be a nothing character. Like, to me, he's a low tier character because I beat him easily with Ermac. So I mean, that's why I don't ever like learn some characters. I don't learn because I beat him easily. Like I started out playing with Jason Voorhees, but I really don't learn him because I beat him so easily. But Predator, I've had so much success. I haven't really played against any good Predators except for Fred's. And I'm not gonna lie, Fred demolished my Predator multiple times with his Predator. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. No matter how much I switch variations or whatever, he destroyed my Predator every single time. Oh my God, Fred is such a beast though. He's really good. And like I said, I'll have to start recording some matches with me and Fred. Even if I lose, I'll have to just go ahead and post them on my channel. You guys can see. He's really good though. He's really good. He only knew, I think, one combo. And that was with the Hunter variation, where he basically used the traps and then he jumps up. It's like basic combos, but he only does like the same one, but he's good at it though. Fred doesn't really drop combos. He's possibly one of the best combos out there, to be honest. He doesn't really drop too many. Like, no lie, he doesn't even play with Sub-Zero, I don't think. He might have picked up Sub-Zero now. But he's the same like this guy here, Mad Dog. He watches YouTube videos and then he sees the combos that people do on there, and then he does those combos and kind of upgrades some of them. He kind of makes them better. But he's so good at it that he can pick up like combos like it's nothing just by watching somebody else do them. And that's crazy to me, because me, I create all my own combos, and I've never been able to pick up on somebody's comboing like that. I've never been that type of guy. That's why I always just create my own. But look at this, I go ahead and beast on this Kung Jin a little bit right here, and I throw down the snare trap, and normally he would just kind of come in on me, but he didn't come in. So I was like, I kind of wish that snare trap would stay there even if you get hit, just for a specific amount of time. But I mean, that's just like with the self-detonate that Predator has. I kind of wish that it wouldn't go away if you get hit. And then like the disc that you throw, I kind of wish that wouldn't go away if you get hit, once you get hit either. But I mean, I understand why they did it. It's for balancing purposes, because Predator is already really, really, really good. So they probably created him, and then once he got put out there, they probably had some guys test him out, and they were like, hey, nah, He's too beast. You're gonna have to change up all of his moves. He probably had a shoulder cannon on every variation, and they probably said, nah, take this off. He only needed one. No telling. It's no telling. And some people saying he need to be nerfed, but and a lot of people saying that the nerf's coming for Predator. But to be honest, I don't think he needs a nerf. At first I was like, maybe he needs a nerf just a little bit, possibly. I don't know. But now, since I've been playing with him, nah, I don't think he needs a nerf, because he can get ranged out really easily. Like, if you don't have that Hish, whatever that variation is, if you don't have that specific variation, then Predator can be ranged out really, really easily. And look at this, and I love that staff attack. It has so much range on there. You can pretty much use that. As long as you have meter with Predator, you're good. But once you run out of that meter, then it's pretty much a wrap for you. But as long as you do have that meter, then you should be okay for the most part. And look at this. Even no matter if you do a fatality or not, like I said before, if you do a fatality or not, Predator's still going to kill him no matter what. He's still going to kill his enemy. So just look forward to dying every time you fight Predator. But I love the things that Kung Jin says. Like, he's like, oh, you can't hurt me. And then once he finishes fighting Predator ends up killing him, and then he always screams. It's so funny. But look at this. I'm just basically just doing this over and over, because he really didn't seem like he knew how to stop it. But look at his blocking though. And finally, I get through to him. Check out this 51% combo right here. Oh my god. I told him before. I said, hey, 51% coming up. And he was like, what? He was like, whatever. You're not going to pull off a 51. Predator just came out. And I dropped the 51 on him right there. Oh my god. It's so funny. And if he wouldn't have, like, if he would have blocked right there, I still would have blew that, snare trap up. So, if he would have tried to attack me, it would have got him. And so far, he hadn't been able to stop that specific attack that I do. Look at that. And he comes through, but whenever I throw the snare trap behind him, and then I start a combo string and then blow it up, it always catches him every time for some reason. I guess it's because he thinks that it's not going to get him. And I don't know, maybe it's because he forgets. But look at that. Snare trap catches him right there. And I don't know what I was doing right there. I completely failed. I've actually gotten a lot better since this video right here. I've actually gotten a whole lot better. I've changed the way that I play with Predator. I've created more combos that I can do. Look at this. And that was a big mistake on my end right there. I don't know why I did that. And I just did this to try to reduce some of that chip damage that I take, but it didn't really work out for me too much. Look at this. I end up getting rocked right here, but I still win the match. So that's all that matters. But I make a lot of early mistakes with Predator. Even though I didn't really lose, that kind of just shows how strong Predator truly is as a character. That no matter what you do, he has a lot of pressure. His pressure game is really good. And like I said, I don't know if his stuff is positive on block or not. Maybe it's just because he's just been released that people just truly don't know how to block his stuff just yet. But I mean, me, I could do some of this stuff. I can do all day. I've beaten people just simply doing the same move over and over and over and over and over. This move right here. Well, actually, let me see. Ah, he kind of got away from me right there. But once you get in the corner with that, some people just never get out of it. Check this out. But look at that. Oh my god, I'm pulling out those combos in this match. But I throw a nice little snare trap at him right there. But this move right there, that's what I do pretty much. I pretty much do that, and some people can never get out of it. But I normally don't put the grab any in, just like I was just doing there. Once you don't put that grab in the end, then you can just pretty much keep doing that same move over and over and over. And people just can't stop it. I don't know. It just seems like people just can't stop that move for some reason. So they might nerf that. They might make it, like, I guess, negative on block or something. Like, more negative than what it is. Or if it's positive, they might make it negative. I don't know. Hopefully they don't nerf Predator, because he doesn't really need a nerf, because he doesn't have hardly any range. Except for that one attack. Well, he has a couple attacks. Like, he has a couple just like basic moves, like the staff move that he has. His down forward is a lot of people say it's not that good, but I think it's pretty good because it has a lot of range on there. I mean, he uses the staff and he just kind of pokes you with it, and it's supposed to be his low kick, but I mean, it's a hit with the staff pretty much. His down forward. And I know you guys are probably like, man, Mike might know the button mashes and stuff now, because at first I didn't really ever say anything. I always just said front kick, back kick, whatever. I didn't really care to learn the numbers and everything like that. But I'm getting a little better at it. I'm getting a little better at it. And look at that staff attack right there. Oh my god, that's so nice. I like that because it has a lot of range. That's his back 2-2, and it's really good. It's really good. It has a lot of range on there. And it actually pops you in the air. In some situations, it'll pop you in the air, and then you can throw the disc, and then it'll combo in. You might see me in some like upcoming combo videos. You might actually see me doing that in some of my like newer combo videos. It's pretty cool. I figured out how to do some really cool things with the healing, where you can heal yourself during a combo. And I'll actually upload that pretty soon as well. But I figured out how to, like, give myself back health, which I thought was pretty cool. And I might actually start doing that in matches. Like, I might actually start, throwing snare traps out. And then while I'm behind the snare trap, throw out, like, a disc. And then once I throw out the disc, then I might just heal up. And that'll kind of make people want to come towards me, because they don't want to just sit there and let me just gain health back. That's what I might actually start doing. which I think that's a pretty cool idea, because sometimes I'll just be sitting back there not doing anything, and some characters really can't get, like, they can't get to me. Like, if I'm playing against Jason Voorhees and they're using the unstoppable variation, he can't get to you. I mean, only way he can get to you is he has to, like, meter burn through the trap. And other than that, most of the people, they don't want to meter burn through a trap if you're full screen and risk trying to come all the way full screen to stop you from healing yourself. I mean, so, and just like Kung Jin, sometimes in some variations, like, people don't really want to shoot the arrows for some reason. I don't know. They, like, to be honest, if I was playing Kung Jin, I would have been using them arrows pretty much the entire match. I'd have been trying to make Predator come in, and then once I get him to come in, then that's when I would do that jump in dash kick that Kung Lao and Kung Jin both have. I would have been doing that, like, kind of later on, but I see a lot of people doing that same exact combo with Kung Jin. And look at this. Like I said before, I catch this dude every time I do that. Every time. That's why I love having meter with Predator. Whenever I have meter with Predator, I can pretty much, look at that. He fails right there, and I just pull off the quick uppercut. But whenever I have meter with Predator, it's almost automatic for me to do good, because with Predator, in this specific variation, once you throw down that snare trap and you meter burn, if you do the, what is it, the 3-2, if you do the 3-2 string and then you throw down that snare trap, it's almost automatic, because people, it just kind of seems like they don't know how to block it right now. Eventually, I mean, Fred, when I was playing Fred was blocking it every time. To be honest, Fred was blocking every single string I was throwing out. Just like this dude here, this dude blocks almost everything, but a lot of the times people just don't expect it. Look at that, he meter burns through right there. I actually was about to blow that trap up, that snare trap, and it probably would have bounced him in the air, because I didn't throw it far, I just threw it kind of right there. It goes off the screen, so people kind of ignores it, and they really just forget it's there. But look at this, I just kind of chip him out right there. Oh, I play it safe and just chip him out. But I've also been watching some tournaments as well. That's another thing I wanted to talk about. I've been watching some tournaments. I've been watching a lot of Sonic Fox playing. I've been watching a lot of, like, I saw the most recent, I think it was called the ESL tournament, which was, it was like season one ESL. It was about 7 hours. I watched the entire thing. I was bored, and I did it yesterday. I was pretty bored. I was like, I want to watch the tournament and see what's going on. And Sonic Fox finally switched from Aaron Black, which I think people have been already saying he's been playing with other characters. I think he was playing with Ermac at one point in time. And I saw that. And I mean, he's pretty good with Ermac. I play with Ermac, and a lot of people play with Ermac the same way. But me and Sonic Fox, we play completely different from everybody else. Sonic Fox completely rushes with him. And me, I range people out I range people out with Ermac, so it's a lot of fun. It's so funny to see how different, like, people play with Aaron Black. I mean, not Aaron Black's, Ermac, sorry. But look at that. People just never expect that. They never block low for that specific attack, because they never expect it. Look at that. Caught him again with it. And eventually, I mean, if I do it too many times, people will start catching it. But as long as you got meter, like I say, people never block low when you first throw it out. They initially block low later. Look at that. And it caught him again. And that time, it wasn't even meter burned, which is so funny. But look at this. He just goes ahead and backs up. But, I mean, look at this. It's almost like he's showing so much respect, he doesn't even know what to do. Look at this. And that's why I say that's the only thing that Predator truly has, is just that little disc that he throws out. I mean, and that really doesn't even work majority of the times. I mean, you have to pretty much time everything. Look at that. Now go ahead and meter burn it. And I was trying to go for that brutality right there where he pretty much rips your head off. Not this one, but the other one. And I don't know if you guys know, but that other brutality that I've been doing, that's a secret brutality. At first I wasn't doing it because I didn't know it, but I know it now, and I'll actually tell you guys how to do that specific brutality. When you do the 3-2 string, and then you can pretty much do the command grab right after that. You can just press L1 or the command grab. You can just, whatever the buttons is, however you do the command grab, you just press that button, and it'll actually grab him, and then like he'll stick his blade in his in their like neck, I guess in the lower part of their neck or chin or whatever. And if you hold two after you do that, then it'll actually rip their head off. And I might do the brutality again. I can't remember. There's so many matches that I played, but yeah, it'll actually rip their head off. So that's how you do that specific brutality. And look at this. Oh my god. And I know he was getting pretty frustrated when we were playing because I kept breaking every combo he would get into. And that's it right there. That's the string I was talking about. As long as you hold two after that, and then it'll go into the secret brutality. So Predator actually has 6 brutalities, and I've performed every single brutality with Predator so far. They're all really easy to pull off, every single last one of them. The one that I do the least is possibly his X-ray brutality. That's the one that I do the least. And once you do that brutality, I mean, okay, when he's in the Hishkin 2 or whatever, when he's in that brutality, all you have to do is shoot him with the shoulder cannon, and that's not hard to pull off at all. You just shoot him with it, and then it'll pretty much go into brutality mode with Predator. And then when you're in Warrior, all you have to do is be in detonate for the last hit. The final hit, you have to be set on self-detonate. And what I do to pull that off is I just normally beat people up and then finish whatever combo that I'm doing with the self-detonate, and then I just run up to people and just start attacking them. I just keep doing the same string over and over and over and over and over, and it just kind of keeps them in defensive, or I'll low poke them, or I'll just stay back completely and just run up, and then it'll self-detonate. And it's so funny because people really, some people don't know what you're doing when you go for the brutality and Warrior, and some people are actually like, they'll actually try to attack. Sometimes I'll just backdash on them and then just run right back up, and that'll catch them sometimes. And it's pretty funny when you do the self-detonate, because people don't expect it. They just like, what? And then for what other? Oh yeah, he also has the Hunter variation one, which is the snare trap. All you have to do is just throw a snare trap at their feet and meter burn it. And most of the time, the chip damage will pretty much take them out, because it does a lot of damage. So if they're low in health, just throw a snare trap at their feet, or you can do it in a combo. There are some really good strings. Like, look at that. I mean, I catch them with snare traps all day, so doing the actual brutality itself is not really a problem. And then here's his other brutality. This is the one I was talking about right here. I don't know why I didn't do the brutality itself right there. But all you have to do is just hold. Like I was saying before, all you have to do is just hold two. And then it'll brutality. And maybe it's because I wanted to do the fatality. I don't know. I can't remember the reason why I didn't do it. But that's how you do that specific, the secret brutality. And then also he has the brutality where you do the X-ray. Which all you have to do is hold down during the X-ray. When the disc hits their neck, it's gonna cut his head off. That's how you do that specific brutality. And then his final one is you just do the command grab, which you don't do any string with it or anything. You just do the command. I mean, you can do a combo and then do the string, and then you just hold up, and holding up will actually just cut him in half. It'll cut him. He'll just kind of like cut their whole body in half, pretty much cut their legs off from their stomach. So all of his brutalities are pretty easy. It's not anything hard about any of his brutalities. I pull them all off pretty easily. Predator is actually possibly the character who I've done the most brutalities with. Almost every time I play, I can pull off a brutality. It seems like it's not hard to do brutalities with Predator. I mean, because every time you finish, like whenever you're playing, you can pretty much finish every string with a brutality style move. I mean, unless you're in some situation where you don't have meter, you're far away, and then you have to get off like one of those like moves where he just kind of jumps full screen and then hits you with that blade. If that's the only like situation I can see where you, and look at this, he tries to range me out now. Look at this, he finally tries to range me out, even though it's still not gonna work. Like I said, Predator's so beast, it's still not gonna work. And look at this, I catch him with the snare trap yet again. Like I said before, the snare trap is just completely beast. Look at that. Look at that. I kind of played with him a little bit. And I've actually seen a video where this guy was at tournament, and he actually threw a snare trap out at this guy's feet, and all he had to do was just let the guy fall down, and he would have landed. Like, he was holding on to the vine, and he threw a snare trap at the guy's feet with Predator, and Meter burned it. All he had to do was let the guy fall down, and the snare trap would have caught him. But instead, he jumped up and hit the guy. And if the snare trap had caught him, all he had to do was walk up and uppercut the guy, because that guy's health was so low. Because he jumped over and hit him, he actually lost the match because of it. And the snare trap was in the perfect spot. The guy would have, once he would have ran out of stamina, he would have dropped down right on the snare trap, and it could have been an easy win. And look at it. There's that fake brutality I was talking about right there. That's the secret brutality. And we're coming up on the very last match here. This is the last match. Like I said, this dude has so many characters. He said this was his first day playing, but he has so many characters. He's pretty good with everybody he played with. It didn't seem like, you know, he was saying for this to be his first day. I don't believe that. Maybe he was just saying that for something. I don't know. And look at this. Like I said before, I catch this dude repeatedly trying to come straight at me. Like, look at this. He was about to teleport on me. I mean, not teleport, but he was about to do the Superman on me. Look at this. I catch him again. Oh my God. He never expects any of these snare traps. The snare traps throw him off so much. And I guess that's why they're called snare traps, because it just throws people off. When you meter burn, like I say, people just, I don't know. They don't expect it. They don't block low immediately. They always wait a second. Like, look at that. Like, if you notice, when I throw a snare trap at him and I don't meter burn, he look, see? See what I mean? He's still stand blocking, and then after time, then he'll finally duck block. And I guess it's because he's gotten conditioned, and that's why I like doing the 3-2 so much, because it kind of conditions people to stand block the entire time. Nobody wants to, like, low block on Predator if you're doing that same string over and over. That's why I really don't do the other string. Look at that. See, I've caught him again with that 3-2 string. And look at that. I catch him with the snare trap yet again. Like I say, I mean, every single time I catch him with this snare trap, look at this. And I go ahead and finish him off. You know, about 18 matches I've beaten this dude in a row. But these were some really good games, though. And I love playing with Predator. Predator's a really cool character. I mean, I can't get enough of him. I mean, in Call of Duty, he was a beast. And in this game, he's a beast. So, hey. As long as they keep throwing Predator out, I'm going to keep buying whatever game he's in, because he's beasting and everything. But I want to thank you guys for watching, checking out my videos, and peace.